but they are further to spiritual quality to enhance and further spiritually high quality level of fast, and they are at 8. And we have details of that on our VCD as well. Similarly, many people complain about prayers, about salah. There are 10 levels to increase the spiritual quality of your salah. It's not a quick fix that you can quick fix in one day. Those are their levels. So person, all that person is trained in all these disciplines in this during this course. And then zakah as well, spiritual levels of Hajj and Umrah. All these are there. And some books that person will be recommended, this is recommended, and the seerah of Rasulullah, which he's trying to follow. So these are, this is actually the copies of the file which everyone is given. So at the end we say Hazrat Sufyan bin Uyainiyah and Hazrat Qatada rahimahullah said the meaning of the verse qad aflaha man zakkaha, successful is the one who purifies his soul is by obeying Allah and performing righteous deeds. Goodness cannot grow and develop unless one leaves evil, in the same way that a plant cannot develop unless the ground or soil around is touched. Similarly, the soul and deeds are not purified until what negates that is removed. This is the saying of the early scholar. A person cannot be purified unless he abandons evil. The soul that does not abandon evil cannot be purified at all, for the evil pollutes and soils the soul. Ibn Qutaybah rahimahullah said, the words corrupts, qad khaba man dassaha, the corrupts it in the above verse means that he has concealed it by covering with the sins, which we have discussed in the first stage, second and third stage. So now we very quickly, why people do not purify themselves, or there is an obstacle, or this might be, some people they are in this attitude, why start tomorrow? But tomorrow Angel Israel might visit you. Will you tell him that I want to be purified? No, he will give you the message, if you have not been purified, you will be purified in the fire of hell. There is no alternative, unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala favors you and forgives you with out of His mercy. Start tomorrow, remember, never comes. Tomorrow kabhi nahi aati. When you go to the day tomorrow, then there is another tomorrow. So is there any end to the tomorrow? No. Your life will end, but tomorrow won't come. So you be heedful, and laziness actually that will take with hellfire. Other is lack of understanding and unaware of the need. You don't understand what is purification, as you have an idea now. They don't understand that they need to follow a training course. It is a training, it is not something to acquire by books only or by actually praising Awliya Allah or Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is a part of it. But the major part of it is that which they themselves had to follow, even in the Awliya Allah and Salihin. They are unaware of the need. They don't know what is the need of it, what, where it can take. It is not difficult at all. It is difficult to some extent because, as I said, that every one organ is purified one by one, and that one even is actually divided into 30 days. So only prescription is given to, it is individually tailored. Whatever your level is, you are in kufr level, hypocrisy level if you are not Muslim, or your state of sinfulness, you have committed hundreds of sins, that this course is individually tailored, it's not same for everyone. That is the difference between ta'aleem and tarbiyah. Ta'aleem can be same, tarbiyah have to be self. Like you go to a doctor, your GP, the medicine are separate for every person. They are not same for every person. So it's not difficult if you know the methodology. If you know the methodology and you have the guidance, then little striving will take you further. You've got really no option. You are like sitting on a ship. Ship is sailing towards, let's say, India. You can eat and sleep whenever you want on the ship, but you have no power to change the direction of the ship. Similarly, you are sitting on this face of earth. You are going day by day towards death. This ship is sailing towards death. On this ship, you can eat, you can drink, you can do whatever you want, but you cannot stop the speed of the ship, and you cannot stop the direction of the ship. So this spaceship, the earth you are on, it is going. So if you have no other option other to otherwise, because your return is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I do not have time due to work, family and study. So some people, in this course there is no time asked from the person. It is, you only have to attend once a meeting with us or the guide, He only has to attend one meeting and then he doesn't have to attend. He carries on with his life. And we don't even ask so much time from your 24 hours, only about half an hour, which only you can do it at your home. But you have to have guidance. You only come back if you need guidance. Otherwise, it is designed for those people who work, have family or study, whichever actually they are doing. It will fit in with their category. So that should not be excused. Cannot attend every day or week, there's no requirement for that. For just self-verification, there's no requirement for that. You have to attend every day or week, as I say. Do not have financial means, there's no money cost involved as well. It's free, and if you buy any books, obviously you have to pay, but otherwise there's no cost whatsoever involved. And if you can't even buy the books, alhamdulillah, we can actually also arrange finance for that. So don't stay behind because you have got less money or you are out of pocket. Other is, as I have discussed already, this DIY attitude, that you are starting to actually doing it yourself, reading book, I've got Bukhari, I've got Quran, I've got all the books on the tasawwuf, and I am now becoming actually purified myself. That's what Imam Ghazali, after studying 2 years, inside out, the tasawwuf he studied only 2 years, locked himself up in a room, scholar of that caliber. After 2 years, he even concluded, I cannot be purified until I have followed a guide. So he then went to Hazrat Abu Ali Farmadi, rahmahullah, and actually had to follow. But he studies the tasawwuf. Studying the tasawwuf, many scholars in University of Manchester, in American universities, they are scholars, they say scholars of science of purification, or they study tazkiyah-e-nafs. But they even do not have iman, or the Lord they can guide. It is a completely different thing. It's not that type of knowledge. Time consuming, it's not time consuming, as I said, that you, there's no time, only half an hour to 45 minutes of your time. At your home, they are required, not anything. And you don't have to do anything except some zikr and meditation and recording on the sheets. But there's no other time involved. Already have substantial knowledge of Islam. As I said, knowledge does not suffice. You have to employ that knowledge into action. If you can do it yourself, alhamdulillah, you don't need. But if you find yourself, you're finding it hard. You see, on your opposite side, there's a very knowledgeable enemy, very powerful enemy, which is shaitan. He sometimes misleads scholars. And the scholars say that this proves that he sometimes have knowledge more than the knowledge of scholars. That's why he can mislead scholars. He ends up misleading scholars sometimes. He has such a knowledgeable person who sat and who have actually seen all Anbiya, Awliya Allah. So the enemy in opposition to you is very strong. You cannot fight this war on your own, really. You need guidance. You need guidance. Otherwise, there's very few chances will be successful. Do not want to give allegiance. Bayah. There's no bayah required. In this bayah is, although it is sunnah, but this is farz. Islahi nafs, tazkiyah nafs, haram haram is farz. You do the farz and sunnah, if you bayah wherever you want, you can do, or after you do, it's not required. But you have to, the farz part and the haram part, you have to actually employ that. For that, there's no bayah required at all. It will brainwash me. Some people say it will brainwash me because it is the mind and the heart is brainwashed. Well, it will brainwash you, but it will brainwash the evil in you and fill the goodness. So if this glass has evil in it, this room is dirty, a plate is soiled. To wash the plate, is it bad? Saying, oh, that person has washed. But you have to consider, what has he washed with? Is it washed away evil? If it's washed away evil, that's what it should be. So brainwashing is good when you brainwash any person from evil and actually replace it with goodness. But if you brainwash from goodness and replace it, that is bad. So brainwashing itself, although it takes place, but it only takes place for the good, meaning the evil, hasad, bughl, the sinful acts, you are free from them, not actually that they are replaced by bad ones, but good ones. So it will brainwash you, but for the good. Not educated, cannot read or write, that's no excuse, alhamdulillah, and we can actually give this course to anyone who even cannot read or write, they can take the course, there's a way around it as well. Too old for it, you are never too old for it. If you have not died yet, if you have not seen Angel Israel, then you are not too old for it. If you've seen Angel Israel,